has aspects. Yeah, AGI has aspects of computer science, mathematics, engineering, philosophy of mind, linguistics, neuroscience. It's quite cross-disciplinary, and the education system isn't really that way. It's more that way in the U.S. than anywhere else on the planet, actually. That's a strength the U.S. has. Here, as an undergraduate, you can at least take courses in every department. And in many countries, that's not true. But even in the U.S., the education system is not nearly as cross-disciplinary as it should be for grappling with a problem like AGI, or with, say, quantum computing or nanotechnology or a lot of other cutting-edge things. So what that means is, if someone wants to really work in one of these cutting-edge topics that has the highest probability of transforming the world, if they want to work on these things in the core capacity, they have to take their own time to study a bunch of other fields that they didn't learn in school. And that also takes time. You can't do that by reading a blog post. I mean, you gotta, you know, take out a neuroscience textbook and go through it step by step. And not everyone has the patience for that. But again, some people do. And I'd say Coursera, Udacity, and MIT, the many universities that have put their courseware online, have been a huge, huge asset in this process, because those help lead people through the process of learning information from all the different disciplines that they need to attack something like AGI. We've found these online courses incredibly useful in what we've been doing in Ethiopia. So in 2013, I co-founded with two others Ethiopia's first AI and robotics development company. So we do some original R&D, some projects aimed at helping the African situation, then a bunch of software and robotics outsourcing. Companies called iCog Labs, based in Addis Ababa. And we have an internship program, which we use for recruiting. So we take dozens of undergrad students each year. And what we do, we give them some hands-on lessons in OpenCog and various other AI tools. We also have each of them take like 7 Coursera courses. And they go through them very quickly, and they teach them, you know, neuroscience, computational linguistics, bioinformatics, machine learning, a bunch of topics that are not offered in the university there. And this works much better than giving them a bunch of textbooks to read, because it gives them a process and a community to enter into. It not only teaches them information, but it weeds out people who don't have the persistence to slog through stuff from a bunch of different disciplines and really stretch their brain in a deeper cross-disciplinary way. So yeah, I'd say, as with everything else, there's pluses and minuses all tangled up, right? I mean, the modern way of doing things in some ways eliminates people's attention span, because nobody has to think for themselves. They immediately look up the answer on the internet or download something instead of trying to solve a problem themselves. On the other hand, there's so much high quality educational material out there, together with supportive communities for people who do want to plunge in deeper and get a more foundational understanding. Cognitive synergy is a term that I introduced to refer to the process of multiple cognitive processes acting on a common knowledge representation, interacting according to mutual aid rather than just independence or some sort of competitive relationship. So when one cognitive process, like reasoning or vision or creative concept creation, gets stuck and there's so many possibilities in front of it, it can't tell what to do, then it can ask some other cognitive process to come in and help it cut through the confusion. Creating a collection of cognitive processes that covers all the bases needed for a human-like intelligence and that work together in a mutually supportive, synergetic way is not especially easy, and I spent about a decade working on the technical details of that in designing the OpenCog system together with a number of my colleagues.